Sowa, a person living with disability, the executive director of the Disabled Christian Fellowship International, and organizations which is disabled-centered organizations or persons living with disability organizations. What we do is that we try to empower persons living with disability. We give independent living, and then we'll also do industrial aspect of living. Our membership is about 2,000 across board. We are a registered organization with the Registrar General Department as well as the Department of Social Welfare, which we have as part of our stakeholders, as it were. We also liaise with the other organizations, that is the Ghana Federation of the Physical Disabled, the Ghana Society of the Physical Disabled, and other like-minded persons living with disability organizations. What we do is that, as I think I talked about, empowerment. Empowerment is most central aspect of our developmental goals and policies. And so as a result of that, we try to reach out to person living with disability within our realm. When I say person living with disability, we deal with the blind, the deaf, the physically disabled, and the mentally handicapped. Well, these are the people we really deal with. We are an hour and compassion organizations as such, and so this is what we do. KNC also are one of the core organizations, as it were, you know, civil society organizations that have been able to play a pivotal role in trying to integrate persons living with disability. They see also, as it well, like person living with disability organization, have to identify itself and work in tandems with the situations that is really on the ground. And so as a result of it, we try to liaise with other stakeholders with the implementations of the policies that has been enshrined within the government sectors. When I say the government sectors, you know that there's what we call the Disability Act. And then there's this National Council for Persons with Disability. These are organizations that we really work with. And so we also try to mobilize. We do the mobilizations of our members. And then based upon the mobilizations of our members, we now bring them into the fore to re-engage organizations and governments policies and then try to implement them as it were. SDGs, as you know, aware, it has now been upgraded, I think, about 17 SDGs. And as a result of that, we have actually been able to implement about 11 of them. 11 of them is left with the other one. The first ones, which we are with, creating opportunities, equal opportunities for persons living with disability. The other ones is trying to let people have self-confidence in them and self-esteem and do the necessary actualizations and try to put them into the industrial goals so that they will now be self-independent. And so in my initial submissions, I talked about the self-goals and being independent. It is important that we will be able to explore opportunities of such nature, which we knew to the development goals and the vision and foresight of persons living with disability, so that they may have that self-confidence. They may have to be able to know that they are part and parcel of societies, so that those part of stigmatizations, marginalizations, which we have suffered over the years, are actually now cross-port. Of course, society, I must say, that are based upon the Disability Act of 2006 at 759, it has actually brought a lot of confidence in persons with disability. And government has also explored opportunities as it is, generalized or empowered persons with disability. So school, educations, health centers, and all these things, today we are able to assess. Accessibility is the key. Once we are able to assess situations as it were, we assess the environment, assess the necessary equipment, among other things, I mean, the sky would definitely be our limit. The government will be able to ponder and reflect soberly that we are part and parcel of, because the United Nations or the World Health Organization said about 10% or there or more of persons living with disabilities in every society or in every population constitute persons living with disabilities. So if you look at Ghana populations of about 30 million, then it denotes that about 3 million or thereabouts or more. Accessibility is not about, you know, gadgets and other things. Accessibility is caused about even assuming I'm a person with visual impairment and I don't have the necessary gadgets to be able to see the walking sticks or the braille sticks and all those things, or I don't have the braille to even assess what is being done, or I'm a person with hearing impairment and I cannot actually hear what is really going on, where there will be sign language and other things. These are challenges that we have. And more importantly, for those of us who cross on all fours and use gadgets like wheelchairs and among others, or calipers and other things, if government have not been able to put these gadgets in use and do this in the social aspect, we have a sincere, severe challenges. And I think if government will bring the necessary resources to our fold, I think by and large, government is more discerning that we are part and parcel of the society. I think definitely will also be have that inclusiveness of society.